find out about Barry's time travel and maybe have a conversation with him about that.
No, I hope so. I'm desperate to work with Grant as well. I've been hanging out a bit. He's so good. I think it'd be great. I think it'd be great to explore that. I have no idea if it's happening. But yeah, it's happening. I'm lying.
Have you guys started your Vancouver band yet?
No, we haven't. It's just me solo again. I don't know.
Jesse Mark talked about
it. Yeah. He wanted to have Flash. No, I want my own name. Rip and the Hero. Arthur and the Hero. Yeah, there's so many people who play music up there. But we always have these grand ideas of spending our weekends like writing a hit album, and we end up just like, sleeping.
Well, I have a question about last season. Rip kind of was not the best of captains.
What do you mean?
He lied to his crew, he deceived them, he led them into a couple of time messes, I would say. So how is Rip, I know that's weighing on him, but how is he going to like improve on that this season?
He's such a funny character because he thinks he's so great at what he does. But he thinks that his intentions are the best intentions. I think he's had a bit of time to reflect when we meet him. But I think what he went through last season has definitely damaged him. And I think I'm very aware of doing is he's got a real internal sadness, and that's what's happening. He's lost so much and failed so hard. And it's something that he'll never be able to get back. He's lost part of himself. But also I've been promised that we get to see more of his lighter side as well. I'm excited to see that. When we meet him, he's like a kind of exasperated parent whose kids just won't stop like colouring in the walls. He's got to the point where he's like, I don't know what to do with him. But then very early on there's a big twist. Quite early on in the series, which changes absolutely everything for him. Which is very exciting. And the sequel.
So now that Rip has come to terms with saving his name,
yeah.
What is the kind of driving force for him?
Well, they've also destroyed the Time Masters, so he feels a responsibility to preserve, to keep time ticking, as it were. And very soon we find that there is someone who's trying to stop them from doing it. We meet quite a big foe quite early on. Very quickly takes their attention, and then it just sets up.
If Flask is on the team already, you get them very soon. It will be a new addition to that. Everybody will be fight club.
I haven't read it yet, so I don't know. I think so. Like, what's so great about introducing all these new characters is that there are so many egos flying around. You know, they've all got a similar aim, just to keep everyone safe and happy. There's a lot of cooks stirring the pot, and I think that very quickly makes some quite tense situations. It's like in my life, I'm so afraid of confrontation that I can just live it out at work.
Are
do you think Rick would take to have you worry on the show?
Yeah, I don't think he'd be like, Jesus Christ. This guy's not very good at being brave. I don't think Rory would deal very well. I don't know, he steps up occasionally. Maybe Roman Rory would be. That would be weird having to do
like. Yeah, wouldn't it?
You'd have to shave in between. Glove?
Well, theory that Rory, you know, became
red. I've only played one character my entire career.
You time traveled your career. Yeah,
it's just Rip in disguise as a different type of thing.